Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to extend an image with AI for free. Now, if you're a graphic designer and you already have Adobe Photoshop, you can use that instead, and you can jump to this timestamp to see how to do that. All right, let's get started. Now there are two websites that you can use. This Uncrop by ClipDrop is a pretty good one, but you only get a few for free. So instead of using that one, you can try phot.ai, and this link will be in the description below. So I'll click upload, and this image that I'm uploading is actually from Bing Image Creator. So I'm going to open that, and I'll choose widescreen 16:9. And we'll generate. This will take some time. Most of the artificial intelligence sites do take a little bit of time, but this looks pretty nice. We have some weirdness going on over here. It would be kind of nice if the bricks extended all the way like they do on this side, but this looks pretty good. I'll choose download and it'll go into my downloads folder. And here's the image. So now we have a horizontal image that we can use for social. It's not a high-res version, and of course there are a few issues with it, but it's pretty good in my opinion. Now if you're already a subscriber to Photoshop, that is going to be a better option because it's free if you've subscribed, of course, and you can make as many as you want. So I'm going to open the same image in Photoshop. I'll hit C on my computer to get to the crop tool, and up here I'm going to choose 16:9 for the ratio. I'll get on a corner and I'm going to hold option to extend this out. And I'll hit enter or return to commit the changes. Now I'll hit M to get on my little rectangular marquee. And I'll draw around this part that I want to fill in. Now I'm including a little bit of the image so that Photoshop knows what to do. And I'll hold shift and do the same thing over here. Then I'm going to use this generative fill bar. If you're not seeing it, it's called the contextual taskbar. It's right up here under window, right here. So I'll click generative fill. Now you can also type in something if you want to see something specific here, but I don't really care. I just want background. So I'll click generate. Photoshop gives us three options, and it actually did quite a bit better than the phot.ai site we are on. This one looks pretty great. I would definitely use this. I'm going to look at the second version by clicking through on the contextual taskbar. This one looks good except for whatever's going on here. And then for the third version, this is probably the best one. So I'll use this one. We can save this file as a Photoshop file, and it'll always have that generative fill layer. And we can click on that and then flip through and maybe grab a different version. So I would save the Photoshop file by going to File, Save As, saving as a Photoshop file like this. And then to make a JPEG, File, Save As, and we can save this as a JPEG or PNG file. And that's it. All right, if you liked this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.